My dear students and viewers, Assalamualaikum. Welcome back to our online class. I am Mushida Imam, Assistant Professor, Department of English, Government Shahid Sohrawardi College, Dhaka. My dear students, today I am going to conduct a class for the students of Honors First Year, Department of English. My dear students, in our previous class, we declared that we will start reading the short story, that is The Garden Party. So today at first I want to give you an idea about the short story The Garden Party and also about the writer of this short story. You know, The Garden Party is a short story and it was written by Kathleen Mansfield. My dear students, Kathleen Mansfield was born in Wellington, New Zealand. She was a modern British short story writer. Only at the age of 19, she left Wellington and she went to England to establish herself as a short story writer. So you see, Kathleen Mansfield was born in Wellington, New Zealand on 14th October 1888 into a middle class colonial family, and she left New Zealand at the age of 19 to establish herself in England as a writer. And my dear students, Kathleen Mansfield has deep interest in human psychology. She shows deep psychological insight in drawing her characters for her stories. Her short story is distinguished by psychological interest. Her short stories deal with the psychological problems of the characters. There is nothing sensational, no high drama in her stories. She places sensitive finger on the pulse of the lives described. She takes some small incident of everyday life, some personal meeting or conversation, and makes the scene and atmosphere. Okay, and in The Garden Party, that is we are going to read, that is in The Garden Party, Mansfield uses the incident of the death of a young man in the neighborhood to trace the development of Laura from adolescence to maturity. And the story The Garden Party was written in 1922, and at the center of the story lies Kathleen Mansfield's concept of life. The story centers on the development of the little girl Laura Sheridan, the protagonist of the story. And through her story, The Garden Party, Kathleen Mansfield portrays a young woman's struggle through adolescence and her tumultuous entrance into adulthood. Kathleen Mansfield's major works are like that. There is the name of some short stories I am going to mention. That is The Garden Party, Miss Brill, The Doll's House, Prelude, The Fly, Bliss, A Cup of Tea, At the Bay, etc. are some famous short stories by Kathleen Mansfield. She died on 9 January 1923, only at the age of 34, in France. My dear students, now I would like to tell you the story of the story in brief, that is the short story The Garden Party. I will tell you in brief the story of the short story, that is The Garden Party. Here you will see the first line of the story is like that. And after all, the weather was ideal. They could not have had a more perfect day for a garden party if they had ordered it. And students, in these two lines are the very starting lines of the short story The Garden Party by Kathleen Mansfield. So here you see that the sudden beginning, and after all, the weather was ideal. So here the characteristics of the short story, that is the sudden beginning, is to be noted here. So here we see that on a warm summer morning, that is Laura and her mother, along with her sisters Meg and Josie, are at home hurriedly working on the preparation of the garden party they are holding that afternoon. That is, the Sheridan's family are going to celebrate a garden party, okay, and they were taking preparation. And here you see that the while the Sheridan's family are having breakfast, Laura is supervising the workers who have to put up the marquee. Okay, marquee. Okay, the marquee means a large tent used for social or commercial functions. That is, they are going to arrange a garden party. And so here you see that Laura is supervising the workers to put up the marquee. She addresses the workers in an authoritative way in an attempt to imitate her mother. And you see, Laura is the youngest member of the family, and her mother asks her to supervise the garden party, okay, to arrange the party, how to decorate the garden. Okay, she likes one of the workers, and because of this, she thinks they are charming and nice guys. Here, the psychological development of Laura is to be noted here. But Laura seems to be very superficial. Then she takes a very big bite of her bread and butter to prove that she is with them and that that she doesn't care about conventions. But in fact, she forgets them when she is making the arrangements for the garden party. Here, and then we see that later they learn that a man who lived in one of the poor houses near Laura's house has died in an accident. And here's the turning point of the story, my dear students. That is, while Laura was supervising the works of the workers in the garden, suddenly she got a message that is a poor neighbor, okay, close to their neighbors, one of their neighbors has died in an accident. Laura feels very sad and she wants to stop the party. But what happens, my dear students? That is, her sister, her mother, and all other family members, okay, consider this an absurd idea. Why they will stop the party? Here, my dear students, class distinction is to be noted here, okay. That is, the neighbor was very poor. They are not at their status, okay. So they don't want to stop the party. Why? Okay, so here you see that the preparations for the party go on, and finally it takes place. That is, the garden party was held. And when everything is over, my dear students, you will see that when we'll go through the text, we will see that when everything is over, Mrs. Sheridan, that is the mother of Laura Sheridan, suggests that they could take the leftovers to the dead man's family. That is, the food which was extra in the party. They Mrs. Sheridan wants that they could give the food to the dead man's family. And Laura thinks that this is not a good idea, but she accepts and does as her mother suggests. So here we see that Laura will will go to the to the dead man's family with this food and wearing his party dress. Okay, it was also very Laura was very much ashamed of that wearing the party dress. She's going to a dead man's family and with leftover foods. Okay. And here they see that Laura thinks that this is not a good idea, but she accepts. Why? Because her mother suggests. When she arrives at the dead man's house, everybody looks at her and she just wants to get away. When she manages to see the corpse, that is the dead body of the of his neighbor, she feels much better because the man looks as if he were dreaming. His sleeping face gives her the impression of peace and calmness. And here we'll see the end of the short story, the garden party. So my dear students, you see, apparently the theme of the short story, the garden party, is very simple. All conversations and descriptions were about the garden party and the death of the poor young man who left his wife and 5 children behind. The people in the family are divided into 2 groups by their reactions to the death of the young man, Scott. Okay, the neighbor who died, his name was Scott. Okay, Scott, the death of the young man, Scott. Laura showed her sympathy and tried to call off the party because Scott's family lived in a cottage near the Sheridan family. But you see that her mother could not understand her and insisted on the party. And the party went on successfully as planned. Everybody was having a good time, including Laura. However, when Laurie, her brother, that is brother of Laura, came back from work, showed his sympathy. Mrs. Sheridan changed mind and asked Laura to send a basket of food to the Scott's family. She saw the body of the young man there and came back in tears. When she met Laurie on her way back, she knew that life is marvelous. Okay, and critics opine that the idea in the garden party is how marvelous life is, even a miserable and poor life. That is, in the opinion of many of the critics, the author wants to tell that it's important to show sympathy and understanding across traditional class borders. And my dear students, what Laura and Mrs. Sheridan learned about life and people is at the center of the story. And Catherine Mansfield, The Garden Party is a story about class consciousness. Class consciousness. That is, in the story, the writer shows through the depiction of our characters and their attitudes and mannerisms that how the people belonging to the affluent section of the society look down upon the people with less property and dignity in the society. Laura's mother is a woman who belongs to a wealthy family. Hence, she thinks that it is not proper to let her issues mix with the poor people. So when a poor man dies in one of the neighboring poor families, and when Laura comes to her mother with a proposal to stop the party, she gets surprised and thinks it unwise from her daughter even to think like that. Throughout the story, class consciousness or class distinction, okay, my dear students, that is class distinction, runs as an underlying theme in the garden party. Again, death has an overpowering presence in the story, in the garden party. That is, Catherine Mansfield explores profoundly the world of death and its impact on a person in her short story, The Garden Party. The sense of gaiety in the story surrounding the party and its preparation is marred slightly by the death of a poverty-stricken neighbor. Laura, the protagonist of the story, is a young girl of the Sheridans, you see, and a wealthy high-class family who lives in England. And Laura's world revolves around the finer things in life, garden parties and flowers. And she has been surrounded by beauty her whole life. She's unlike her other family members in the sense that she's sympathetic to the poor while other is not. So here we see the comparison of the characters. That is, I am repeating the line. That is, she is unlike, that is, Laura is unlike her other family members in the sense that she is sympathetic to the poor while other is not. She has been protected from the real world, so she has never experienced the effects of betrayal, poverty or labor, let alone death, which she does get to experience by the end of the story. Laura meets face to face with death, and the result of it changes her look on life forever. She learns about life at the end of the story and thus becomes mature. At the conclusion of the garden party, Laura is exposed to a side of life she has never encountered before and comes to a sudden realization that life and death may indeed coexist and that their common existence in one world may be beautiful. Death is not necessarily associated with ugliness, she learns, but rather it is a natural process which she likens to sound, peaceful sleep. So, my dear students, here we see that The Garden Party is a story about a young girl's development into maturity. The main focus of the story is on the character of Laura, the protagonist of the story, and the development of her character. Through her short story, The Garden Party, Catherine Mansfield portrays a young woman's struggle through adolescence and her tumultuous entrance into adulthood. Okay. The ending of The Garden Party is typical to Catherine Mansfield. She usually leaves these things unstated for the reader to interpret in their own ways. Okay. Or to surmise what happens next. That is, the story ends in Laura's visit in the poor dead man's family and with her experience that paves the way for her to understand what life really means. It is customary to Catherine Mansfield to end her stories with a question without answering it, leaving the reader to ponder or to ponder what happens next. So the ending of the short story The Garden Party is no exception. The ending of the story alludes to the fact that young Laura, born and brought up in a sophisticated and refined family, has learned a great lesson about life. So, the ending of the story is very powerful, indicating a development in the personality and mentality of the protagonist, Laura Sheridan. She had just visited a dead man's family after hosting an extravagant party, basically on their doorstep, and the experience was marvelous. So, my dear students, that's all about the short story, The Garden Party by Catherine Mansfield, in short. And in our next class, my dear students, if you are agreed with me, we'll arrange a Zoom class, and on that class, we'll start reading the text, that is the short story, The Garden Party by Catherine Mansfield. So, my dear students, no more today. See you again in our next class. Till then, be happy. Goodbye. Allah Hafiz.